see. First things first, we need to check out some elevators. Let's see. Let's see what we have for specials. Nothing new here. Structures. Here it is. The warehouses. This is new. It's not bad. Corner wall. Roof. Roof. Corner wall. Roof. Alright. Warehouse floors. Let me check that out. Walls. These warehouse walls ain't bad. Damn it, they have to be so high. How high are these? Oh well, literally fits right on top of it. Interesting. Warehouse doors. This one I like. So this could fit right there? This or no? Let's find out. No, it's not gonna fit here. It's too low. Check that out. Oh yeah, that's way too high. Alright, we can put that away. Now let's check this out. Posts. Actually, that's not a bad one. Roof cupola. The stairs. Okay, these gonna go right in the ground. Perfect. Let's see what else. These are the normal ones. Can also go up and down. All right, cool. That works. I like that. Let's see. So this is already, oh, scaffolding. Oh shit. Holy fuck. Prefabs of scaffolding, you can build straight up on shit. Whoa, I like that shit. So you can build straight up. Bro, that's actually pretty fucking cool. You could build right in the center of this thing, straight up. Not bad. Scaffolding floors. Oh, these are nice. It's a good floor. Framework. Can go up and down. That's cool. It's about time they put some scaffolding in here. That's actually pretty cool. I like that a lot, actually. How high does this go? It's not bad. My bad, Petey. My bad. Fuck, man, that's not too bad. I would have gotten on, but I got damn excited. These These are stairs? Okay, these are the inclines. I could see that. Different types of stairs. Alright. That's cool. They got all kind of... These are like ramps. Yeah, there you go. It says ramps on it and everything. You raise and lower as you... Really? Dance? Get out of here. These are actual stairs. For the scaffolding. You guys need to get out of the way, man. Those little tiny ones. Oh, wow. They got all types of stairs now. It's actually pretty decent. You can do a lot with these. And railings. And what's this? Boxcars. Okay. Actually not bad. Box cars. I like that. What I want is the elevators, please. I want elevators. There we go. What's this? All these are the tracks for the balls. Any other miscellaneous? Anything new in here? No miscellaneous. Definitely. Our 2-floor, 3-floor, and 4-floor elevators. Now, let's see how these work. Because, I've been working on this shit all day long. To set this shit up for this. Well, the time that I've had, anyways. Where'd you go? Alright, let's see. So it has to be on leveled ground. Let's see what's up. Let's see. Damn, I don't think that's gonna work. It won't work like I want it to, but I can probably make it work whether it wants to or not. Hold on. What's that? Hold on. Alright, I'm gonna have to concentrate on this thing. Let me see. Let's see what I can do here. Some complicated ass shit at times. Alright, you guys are all up in the way. Y'all need to move. Alright, let me look at it from this direction and see what's up. Okay, it won't connect like that. But I can get it close enough. Needs 5 electricity, huh? Not a problem. Alright. Now. Let's see if I can get this thing to work. I want to turn it around, though. So the electrical has to be from this side. Okay, right there. Okay. I got this. Let me see. Remove this. This is literally the one thing that I wanted most of, the most in this entire DLC, and well, in everything of Fallout, was a freaking elevator. It looks promising. Looks good over there. Looks. Looks good. I wonder if you can connect pieces of wood directly to it. What was that? Those are conduits. Oh, these are for junction boxes, huh? Oh, shit. Oh, wow. Damn, if I can have junction boxes up going up and down the buildings, it makes it a lot easier than having wires. Hmm. Interesting. No lights? Let me check. Nope. Manufacturing. Well, that's all this stuff. Okay. So this can build shit for you, huh? Interesting. And I need your weapons forge. Oh shit! Mixed ammunition? Oh, hold up. Oh, this makes the fireworks. This is actually pretty fucking decent, man. On the conveyor belts, so you can send it to where you want it. Quite interesting. Yep, definitely gonna need a warehouse. That's for damn sure. And I think I know where I'm gonna build it. Way on the other side. First things first. I need to check this elevator. Stay on point.
Your instincts seem to be right on target.
Okay, so I mean, that's a hell of a drop. It goes slower going down.
Too many folks these days count on violence to solve their problems.
Second floor.
Look around to see where that goes.
Okay. Alright, let's see some stuff here. Let's see what I can do with this. Here we go. Master Builder Prophet. Okay, so you can connect to that. Oh, hello! Okay. That was an actually a damn good drop there, huh? Let's go,
assigned to the same team. I think we can learn a lot from each other.
And here I can actually just put on small stairs and that would be good to go. Okay, I can do that. That would be decent. But I got this. The Damn it, these stairs, I can't get them close enough. Let's see if... I really wanted to get them much closer, but... Alright, let's try the other kinds of stairs that we have here. Might as well, it's got some new stuff anyway, so let's go for it. It's not gonna go straight down like I wanted to. I wish I could put it right through the wood, man. What a shame. Yeah, I can't make this one go either. Shit. Oh well. Let's check the metal ones. Concrete, sorry. Concrete ones, actually, I can get a little closer with them. Oh shit, bullshit. That's far as hell away. Alright, I understand the predicament, and I will go ahead and add... this. And this should, hopefully, fix that small little problem we have. And it does not. But if I do this, then it fits perfectly. Interesting. Alright, let's see if we can glitch this thing out right here and add... No. It's a good try, though. Would have been nice if I could have glitched that out. Okay. Oh well. It was worth a try on that one. But I do have... You're messing with contraptions. Have you tried putting a vacuum hopper on a workbench? I have not yet. I have not done that stuff yet, man. I'm sorry. I wasn't reading the comments, but I've been paying attention to this.
You should make good time when the weather's this clear.
Let me see. I think PD Boys sent me a party invite, so I'll go ahead and grab that. Oh, he didn't send it. Alright. Let's go to floor 2. I literally just downloaded this Contraptions DLC, so I'm working on it and testing out all the possibilities for this. I'm gonna build a door or building around this. I think I just got a party invite now. This one, I know for a fact I'm going to need a stair, a drop stair. And I can build a little ladder right to it from here. Damn it, I wish I could get a little closer, man. Alright. see.
Hello.
Yeah. I don't normally do the party thing during streams because it kills the stream. The internet uses a lot. Alright, now. Let's see. Let me see.
The elevator's badass.
Bro, the elevator is tight work. I'm really excited about the elevator. It's actually the one thing I am most excited about is the freaking elevator, bro.
You should find a way to put power armor suits on it, right? And have them down most of the time on like floor one, and then make it to where you can manually do it from the top. Call it up, like call up power armor, you know? Have them up on a lift. And they're kind of like hidden. Alright.
Like literally going to do a bunch of crazy shit here in this thing. Looks good. Alright, so we got a 4-story elevator. Very nice. I should put an elevator right to the restaurant as well from the outside. But for now, what I was gonna do and see if I could cover the walls to the elevator. And you can. Interesting. Let's see how it looks. Check from over here. Oh, I was gonna say, I thought I just fell off the roof. That's not good. I'll watch yours. Come on, man. Get on top of that damn thing. Alright, here we go. Let's see what that looks like. Is it taking up a lot of space? Actually, that's not bad. You know what? That's not bad at all.
Bro, these armor racks.
That's what I'm going to be checking out in a minute as well.
Not going to lie, and sorry if there's anyone younger than the age of 18, these things totally look like sex dolls. Not going to lie.
Alright, let's see. It does actually close well as well. Bro, that's actually pretty fucking cool, man. Can I put that up there? No. Let's see. Can I put this? No, I know that's gonna fit up there. But that does. Quite interesting. Huh. Hello. Does that go up there? shit. Not bad. Not bad. Not bad. It's all busted, but you know what? I can deal with that. I can definitely deal with that. Damn, my fucking neck is killing me, bro. Not bad. Alright. Alright, let's go down to the third floor.
That looks awesome.
What's that?
The freaking elevator looks awesome.
Alright. I'm already in love with this damn thing.
I'm rebuilding the skeleton for my building right now.
Okay.
It's funny because I just noticed mine's in the same exact spot as yours.
No shit.
Same platform, right next to a tree, kind of.
Alright, cool, I got that one. Down to floor two. Alright, now. Nice. Floor one. Look at Nick Valentine running around all over the place. Freaking chicken with head cut off. Alright, Nick, you need to go, sir. Work off of this. Bro, I am so freaking ecstatic about this deal, this DLC, man. With the stuff that I can do with it now.
It's pretty sick.
Okay, now that I have that sealed up, now to attempt what I've been actually really wanted to do. Seal it up. Okay, that's not gonna work the way I was hoping. But I could always try the concrete and see how that would work, using it in this manner. There we go. Damn, I still have some space left in there. Shit. Are that size. I can't fit these walls, these wall pieces there. Let me see something. What do they have in here that I could probably use? Give me this. Oh! Interesting. That can work. I like that. I can definitely use that.
Call me old fashioned, but there's nothing better than being boots on the ground.
Boots on the ground? Really? Dance? You don't have to dance anymore, dance. And you've got to leave your friends behind. Okay. Not bad, not bad. Not bad, I like what I'm seeing here.
That... He just ran out of glass.
No shit. Alright, let's go upstairs and... Third floor. Alright, let's put this on here. If I would have done the building the way it should have been, I wouldn't have this problem right now. But you know what? It's fine. It's not a big issue. It's not game breaking for me, but you know. Actually, hold on. Oh, but then I cover the button. Can't cover that button. Yeah, if I do that, I cover the button. The whole point is not to cover the button either. I want to be able to call the button. So, let's go ahead and put this on here. Oh yeah, it was the shorter glass that I wanted to put here. There it is. There you go, not bad. Not bad at all. Alright, let's go upstairs. Hey guys, welcome to the channel, guys. This is Prophet. You're watching Prophet Next Gen. And thank you so much for joining. And I hope you enjoy the build for today. If you haven't already seen my channel before, I do huge, enormous... monster crazy builds that would dwarf most builders, and honestly they are quite impressive and they're fun to look at. If you get a chance, please subscribe to my channel. Check out my builds right now. Currently I am doing a tournament arena battle droids with the automatron and workshop DLCs, which are pretty cool. I take designs of people and I make robots out of them and I battle them, and currently I'm on episode 6. Well, I just finished episode 6. I'm currently on episode 7. It just dropped, Conlin. It was during E3 they talked about this, and trust me guys, if you check out my videos you will not be disappointed. I have quality stuff. And most of my videos have really good commentary, funny stuff. It should make most of you laugh. Most of you. Not all. Most. Alright, so that's pretty cool. You know what? I don't like that broken glass there. Remove that one. And it just, literally just dropped today. Like, right there at 12 o'clock. They were a little bit late dropping it, but, you know. Put that over there, push it, perfect. I also have a lot of how-to videos, guys. I show you how to build those. If you haven't checked out my channel, that's the airship and blimps. So I do show you how to make those. I was one of the first to do that. I have a lot of FAW videos, like really high quality. I record with my Elgato HD60, and then I transfer over to my computer and use my Sony Vegas Pro 13 to make the videos that I do. So I try to give you guys the best quality possible. Can I just climb up here? Yeah, that'll work. I can deal with that. Perfect. It is in the PS Store. You have to actually look for it. It's kind of a pain in the ass. They didn't make it too very easy. They did not make it easy at all to find it. It's me, and I have my I have the season pass, and I had to go into the PS store and find it. So just go into add-ons in the PS store, look for add-ons, look for new, and then when you see Fallout there, just click on Fallout. It should be there, and then you can download it. Hopefully that helps. How that looks. They were, for some reason, they weren't dropping the DLC like that, like normally they should have. They did it kind of different, so it took longer for most people to get their DLC. I know I was struggling most of the day, desperately trying to find the DLC. No, I didn't sign up for the mod beta. Well, I did, but Bethesda, I guess, did not wanna. I've had words with them, and they didn't wanna give me the beta. It's kind of a shame, cause I do put their game out there, and I make incredible builds, so they should have. But yeah, me and them had a little problem, so they didn't see fit to give it to me. But it's okay, cause I get to do it now. Let's see what I can do here. But if you guys check me out, you will be happy because I do some crazy, crazy, crazy builds, bro. Yeah, me too, bro. This elevator is probably the most impressive thing to me right now, but I am going to go in and show probably one of the best, besides the elevator, because they have really, really cool stuff here, is the things to set up your armor and your guns. Is this where I was gonna go? No. They have three different elevators. A two-story, three-story, and a four-story elevator. Now, there was some stuff for power armors and armors. That would be in furniture? No? Yes? Petey?
For the power armor stands, I believe it is in decorations.
Decorations? Okay.
It should be right next to the statues.
Oh, there's a lot of stuff in the DLC, man. This one actually has plenty of stuff. It's mostly for contraptions for building. You can actually make ammo now. You can make guns. Have machines that build everything for you. With these... Where are they?
They're in the decorations.
Decorations? Yeah, manufacturing, you see this? This will create machinery that you can build. See, this is a builder. Builds basic items. This is an armor forge. Builds armor from inventory, from its inventory when powered. This one builds weapons. This one builds clothing, energy weapons, heavy weapons, ammunition. Very impressive stuff. So yeah, this one makes mines. This one does fireworks. This one creates, yes, you can have fireworks here and have tubes that make fireworks, and you can actually set up music to go along with the fireworks. So it's quite impressive. There is a lot. There's all kind of hoppers and stuff, though. There's a lot. Sorters. It's quite impressive. It's pretty much left to your imagination what you can do. But oh, I've been playing this quite religiously. I have 700 plus hours in this game, so yeah, that'll tell you. Now decorations. Here we go. Displays power armor display. That. Power armor display. Huh. So this literally has its own lighting. So I put all this lighting in here for nothing today. This is weapons racks. This is the thing that I have been desperate for. Having weapons racks, you know, putting weapons on the walls, pistol rack, weapons rack. Oh ho 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 ho. This is for your display cases. This will be for items, gear, weapons as well. All depends on how you want to put it together. To show off things as trophies as well. So there you go, guys. It's quite a lot. This is for your gear that you have found. So you can set it up and put them anywhere you want. To display the armor that you found, regular armor, male and female stuff. So clothing, whatever, however you feel, that's what you can put in there. So I'll be putting up almost every piece of gear that I have on each one of these mannequins set up on the first floor, or actually the third floor. That's where I'm gonna have all the armor. Yeah, third floor is where I'm gonna have all the armor. So now I literally have to change all this here to put the power armor racks, because these things will have their own lighting. So I will remove all these lights and we are gonna put some power armor things here. We have to see how much electricity it uses, because in fact we can look at that right now. These use one power, only one. Okay, that's cool. I'm going to need about 23 of these things. That sounds fucking funny, but yeah, I'm gonna need about 23 of them for so I can put it on this side and that side. I have way more power armor, but I just moved the power armor that I had from around the different settlements and I put them here. But I guess it's good at the same time because I can remove all this extra lighting that I have, which more than likely I'll end up putting more lighting back again. But putting up the power armor stuff is going to be quite impressive. Okay, now let's start by moving these power armors forward. Go ahead and put some fusion cores in these things. Yeah, as you can see, I have 328 full power cores, fusion cores, and I have a shit ton of extra ones that are already being used. So I can barely hear you.
Yeah, sorry, I turned down my mic a bit.
Oh, there you go. Let me turn this light here. So I'm going to be using a lot of this DLC stuff to fix up all the other builds that I have. I have the Pyramid of Power. That one is trashed. I got rid of that. I'm not going to be working on the Pyramid of Power. But I have a huge arena in Starlight Drive-In, and I have one in Spectacle Island, so I will be using this DLC to fix those up. And but I'll be working mostly in Sanctuary Hills using this DLC. I'm going to be doing a lot of contraption builds since I do most of my work here in Sanctuary Hills. I will be doing a lot of that. Believe it or not, I don't have enough power armor, bro. I have about 100 power armors, but here I have, I think, 23 or 24. I have, like, I think 20, 30 more in Spectacle Island and 6 in Starlight Drive-In. But I have them all over the place, so I can't really remember where I have everything at. It gets hard to remember everything. But this is, I really pretty much made this place because I wanted to show off the power armors. Because I knew the DLC was going to have this. So, because of what the DLC was going to have, and I knew I was going to have power armor suits, display cases, I wanted to have this. So So that was the main point of doing this. So here we go. I want to first put out my first one. Let's go ahead and put on our first power armor display case. So there's, what is the difference between them? It's just color? Yeah, it's just color. This is an orange, red, blue, and this one. All right, we'll just go generic. But as you can see, the power is from behind. The lights are in the front. So we want to put this right there. That would literally be perfect. I wonder, can I put it like that? No, you can't go underneath it, which would have been nice. And that should be good. All right, now since we see how that goes, I'm going to go ahead and move each power armor forward, and then I'm going to add all those racks directly behind them and align them well. I will align them well so it can be all nice and lined, and I'm going to see how I put these power armors, if anything. Just checking something out. No, I was just looking at something to see if I can try and put the power armors direct in them, but no, that wasn't going to work.
Is there new paints for them?
New paints? What'd you say? New paints? I don't know.
New paints for the power armor?
I don't know. I didn't check.
Power armor set right there looks like black. Do you see that?
Oh, that black one is old. The power armor? The black power armor? Yeah.
Oh, that's stock?
No, that's not stock. That's from, from what kind of power armor? This is the Railroad. You can only put that on the T-51.
Oh. I've never used that one before.
Yeah, if you put it on the T-51 and you get the Railroad paint job, you can put that one on there.
Fucking Batman power armor.
Yeah, right? I wish I could have put on my fucking X1. That would have been really nice. Oh, my Tesla armor. That one would have been cool, too. This is funny as hell, bro. You should literally see how much power armor I'm moving. This is exactly what I was telling you earlier today, that I knew I was gonna have to do all this. Constantly moving things back and forth just so I can put the suits on. But Iron Man ain't gonna have shit on me.
Yeah, but Iron Man has machines that probably move the suits by himself.
That he does. He does have machines that move things for you. Move things for him, yeah. That is true.
You're doing it the manual way.
Yeah, I have to manually move everything myself. It kind of sucks. Why'd you have to remind me that Iron Man's awesome compared to me?
I wonder what would happen if you tried putting one of those on the conveyor belts.
A power arm on a conveyor belt. I would more than likely try that, but I don't see it moving. And if it does, it'd be kind of funny. Because I will have it do a go in a big, huge freaking circle all the way around my settlement. Just making my power armor go all the way around.
No, you just get a bunch of your chassis and just go around there just to prove a point.
Actually, chassis would be kind of funny because I could buy a shitload of those. Alright, here we go. That was the last top power on this side. Now, let's go ahead and start adding these in here. Yeah, I know, guys. That looks quite impressive. It's a lot of power armor. I know, but that's nothing compared to what I really have. Alright, here we go. Let's start putting these power armor display cases. Oh, they can... Oh, my God. They connect next to each other, bro.
Well... Fallout 4 is your official game.
Oh lord, they can connect to each other. That's impressive. Bro, you know how many power armors I can put here now? Look at that. They connect directly to each other. Oh man, I'm gonna have to get all the power armors that I have Literally have to get every single power armor I have now. Oh, that is too insane. Oh, Lord. Did I set this up? Wow, that's pretty fucking amazing. I'm quite impressed. No lie, I am really, really, really impressed. I need some space here. Hold on. And just for shits and giggles, I need to see if I can get this thing to line up. And I'm going to test something out. Will they connect backwards like this? In fact, let me check something out. Will they connect back to back? No, they don't connect back to back, but you can slide them a good amount over each other from the back. So you can have them, back to back if you do it this way. And you can put them side to side. They will clamp together. It's not clamping because of the lights up on the ceiling. But look, even better. So you guys could get a good view of it from here. They clamp very well next to each other. There you go. That's what they look like when they clamp next to each other. And it looks like it might have lighting here on the top. If at all, it could be. I know it does have two lights down here at the bottom, which are... I like that a lot. Now, we're going to go ahead and start adding these over here. Ah, these lights up here are going to be a problem. Alright, why am I stuck here? Alright, let's move this thing back. Let's line it up. Oh, you could literally push all the way through the wall. So that's good. That ability is actually good. Turn this light on. There we go. That's what I needed. And I want to line it up as close as possible. That way I can get a good move all the way to the end of the wall. I want them to look really, really good. That means I'm going to have, by tomorrow, I'm going to bring all the other power armors that I have from around the world and just set them up here. Just like go nuts, repainting them all, doing all kind of crazy shit and just setting them all up here. Because, I mean, I'm going to have enough. So, oh, for those of you watching directly on YouTube, this is on PlayStation 4. So there are no mods here. I have no mods. This is all PlayStation 4. Remember, mods haven't dropped yet. It should be dropping this this month. But at the moment, this is no mods. This is just pure work. I have put in massive amounts of work into this game to do what I'm doing here. And this one does not want to clip. Don't know why, but okay. Let's put a new one there. That does not want to clip. Is there a reason why it doesn't clip? Yep, that's why right there. Oh, man. They turned. Okay. So. I already know what I gotta do. Turn it just a bit. When I do stuff like this, it'll... It's a pain in the ass, bro. Honest to God. But in the long run, once I get all the lines perfect and stuff, it's worth it for me. I'm like a big, huge perfectionist in this. If you watch my videos, you'll understand why, bro. See, they're still turning. They are still turning. I don't want them to turn. But maybe if I put it over here, let's see what happens. Let's try this from this direction. I know the computers, the monitors do that. So let's find out if this will work this direction. Well, there's a light on the wall. Durr. Well, there you go. That was the problem right there. Freaking light on the wall. So they can go through the wall, but they can't go through the lights. Okay, now we know. And knowing is half the battle. G.I. Jose. Alright, right here we have an issue, so we're going to go ahead and retry this again. There. That should help, that little angle. Such a small thing, but that'll probably help it from going directly into the wall. If I would have fixed this for and added one that has lines, it would have been a lot easier. Flooring with lines is always the best one. Uh-huh. What's up?
There, now go ahead.
Having flooring that has lines on it is always the easiest thing in the world. It's always the best thing to do is have flooring that already has lines in it. Which, to show you exactly what I'm talking about, here we go. Don't worry, this is a lot quicker. What I'm about to do right now will actually, you'll understand why I said about the lines on the floor. Makes life so much easier. And here we go. Watch, I'm going to pick flooring that has lines in it. Preferably... So we just look for flooring with lines. This right here, these usually work the best. If you want to put lines on the floor, use the small blocks. Those are always the best. So let's go ahead and check the wooden. But you know what? We're using new DLC stuff, so let's go ahead and get some of the DLC flooring. We're going to use this, the warehouse. Use the warehouse flooring. There we go. Let's get some... In fact... This is perfect. I know it's a little weird, because it's warehouse, but you know what? For shits and giggles, we're going to go ahead and just use that and call it a day. Eventually I'll change it, but not today. I just want to show you guys this stuff, what I was talking about with the flooring, using the lines. Okay, furniture, well, decorations, there we go. Now, these power armors are literally all over my ass. Lines are a must in this game. It helps with everything you do. And even having the lines, sometimes you can screw it up. But it just helps a lot if you have them. Little movements here and there for this will help hugely. This should, as you can see, that one should work now. It should go all the way across, hopefully, with no problems. But now we have to remove these ceiling lights because they're in the way. Don't know why.
The build that I'm working on is going to be like the elevator in the dead center of the building, and it's going to kind of go like upwards with the elevator. So like the elevator is going to be dead center, and then it's just going to build around it.
That light's broken. These lights are broken. I need to fix some stuff anyways. But I'm going to run power into this building and connect these as well. So if this starts to go cross over, then I know. See, that's already turning. Then I already know that the issue is with these things. But if I leave this here and just back it up some, it should connect... So now I know that these are glitched somewhat. You won't have perfect connections, but they will stack over each other. So if you're patient, shouldn't be an issue. But the lines on the floor will allow you to see how big the issue is. So you can see how much it's turning. It's continuing to turn. If you just remove one of these and bring it back up to the line again, it should fix itself. And then you can just re-add the other one. And then you have a pretty good connection. Just things I've learned from time and time you doing this, which has been a lot. If I move this somewhat over, I can get... I can't fit another one there. But... I quite possibly could. But... I don't want to get too greedy. How many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh shit! That's a perfect number! Whoa! It's actually not bad at all. Let's see how far off the edge can I get this. I'm almost positive I can get one more in here. Once again, everyone, thank you for joining my channel. Please, if you haven't already, subscribe so you can be notified of all future videos, streams, and events as they come up. I have a lot of Fallout videos, videos that you will enjoy, funny videos, build videos, tournament videos, a lot of really cool stuff. So definitely check out my channel, and it's not just Fallout. I do a lot of how-to videos. Play a lot of games, so guys, definitely check those out. You will not be disappointed. I do show how to build some things here in Fallout. I show a lot of my builds with commentary, stories behind it. I actually give you stories and stuff, so yeah. A lot of cool stuff there, man. Here we go, this is shit. Almost. Alright, so either way, that's not gonna work. We already know that's not gonna work. So I need to put it about halfway. You know what? I can just leave that space there. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna leave that space open because I'm gonna put some other decorative things in the back. I can deal with that. That'll work. Now, to put... activate. Holy shit. Whoa. Get the fuck out of here. It puts the closest power armor to it and... Okay, if it's close enough, it will actually pull the power armor to it and put it on.
That's sick.
Yeah.
Now you know how it feels to be Tony Stark, I guess.
Yeah! I'm Tony Stark, bitch! Oh, they just grabbed the wrong one. That's pretty freaking awesome, man. I like that. This one's too far, the Tesla arm one, but that's fine. That is pretty fucking cool, bro. I'm like really excited about that. That is like really fucking awesome. I'm ecstatic about that. That's... I'm not even gonna lie, that was worth all the trouble not having to put them all back again. I like that. That was pretty fucking cool. The fact that it'll suck it right back in. Suck it! Here, socket. Just like that. It's in there. That is pretty fucking cool. Now, we need to run some power in here. I need to see what it looks like lit up. But let's pull the fusion cores out of it. I want the fusion cores. I want to see what these things look like with lights, bro. We gotta have some lights on this thing. Like, that is like the most important part of this entire thing. This is why I have built this building. This is why I have changed and destroyed the entire building to redo it for this DLC, was because of the power armor stuff and the elevator and the ability to put my gear on mannequins and all that stuff. So I need to make a badass build. We need to have power, people. We're gonna have to have power in here. So let's go bring some power into this bitch. We need power. And just so happens, we have some cables right here. And that, my friends, is very useful. I'm pretty happy about that. Let's see what we can do about this. That's good. Let's drop one right here. Do we have any new different connectors here with stuff? Let me see. Did they? Oh, hold on. Oh, you motherfuckers, bro. They put firing targets.
That's awesome.
Bro, they stole my idea. Remember I had made firing shooting ranges?
Yeah.
They put things so you can make a shooting range, bro. You can have a shooting range.
Hashtag copyright.
Bastards. They got me, bro. They took my idea. But they actually made something that you can actually shoot at. And when you shoot it, I guess it'll go right back because there goes the power switch. That is pretty awesome. I like that. I'm quite impressed with that. That little piece of machinery is actually impressive. I like that. That is pretty freaking awesome. That is pretty cool. It all depends on how you use it, because it can be for something else, because I can see what it is. But if you use your imagination, you can make some pretty cool stuff there. Now let's go ahead and grab this cable, connect it there, reconnect that to that, and bring this cable inside. Now, we're going to run a connector right to here. Where's this going? Is it going underneath? There's no space, so I gotta go all around, all the way around. And the connector is where? I don't know. We'll find that in a second. It's going to put this right here. We will find out in a minute where this is going. And here we go. Let's connect this bad boy. No. No. We have lights, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we have power. Oh, this is too badass right now. Like, totally freaking amazing. I'm like so impressed with this simple DLC. It's a lot of the stuff we've been desperately asking for. Okay. But that is impressive. Let's see what's going on the backside. So that's what we got going on in the back. The connectors are right up there. You can see, so that worked well from over here. It actually allowed the cable to go directly through it, so that's not a bad thing. That actually looks pretty good. It's much better than what I was trying to do earlier with the lighting. I was trying to make my own lighting, and what I had done is put lights on the top and put lights on the floor, but this already has somewhat of the same thing, which does make it way better. That is quite impressive. I like what they did with that. It looks really cool to have these displays for your power armors. Now, since I don't want anyone got behind, but I'm gonna go ahead and add some lights behind them as well and see how that looks to give that extra special lighting. I'm going to go ahead and add these. See what that effect will do for us. Not much, just enough to one per wall. Let's see what this lighting effect will give us. See if it'll brighten it up some. And actually, I like it. I like what it did there. It works. Looks good. This one actually might need a light directly to the side. That one's still kind of dark. I do like what we did there. Let's go ahead and add a light right there. And that should do it. Yeah, it's fucking gorgeous. That is amazing. I like it a lot. That is pretty cool. I like it, man. I like it a lot. I like that. The little lights on it are pretty cool. That is pretty amazing. Once again, guys, this is on PlayStation 4, so there are no mods right now. Since you guys do know there are no mods, so I have no mods on this. This is all from work, over 700 hours into my game. I have been doing builds since day one. Collecting, I am a loot whore. I collected like crazy. I do crazy ass videos on YouTube of Fallout. Huge, enormous monster builds. I create all kind of stuff you guys would love. I could, awesome commentary. I use my Elgato HD60 to record my gameplay at its best quality. Then I transfer it over to my computer and use my Sony Vegas Pro 13 to edit the videos with audio, visuals, all kind of good stuff, to give you the best quality and best possible videos out there. And you guys will enjoy it. Please, if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel so you're notified of all future videos that come available to you, and so you can see all the videos that I do have now. Definitely check that out. And now that's done, let's get back to some building. Commercials. Damn commercials. Prophet, you're a damn commercial. Thank you. Thank you. Come back, gang. No whiskey, no juice, Apple. Please. Apu. Yeah, I liked what I did with these lights back here. They actually helped. Not to have too many, but they actually helped a lot. No, don't move the wall. Is this one broken or something? Oh, I was gonna say. I'll take this one. Actually, before I think I had a problem trying to put these things on here because of the lights that were back there. So we're gonna check that. We have to remove all of these lights so we can put those displays. So all the lighting and all the stuff you have around it, make sure you remove. If you guys are gonna do that, make sure you remove everything that's in the area in the vicinity of the lights of the stands, because they will actually cause it to not sit well and it won't work. So let's go ahead and put a fusion core in each one of these again. Guys, as soon as I'm done with this, I'm going to move down into the next floor. If you haven't already seen, this is the elevator. I will be moving into the first floor, and I will be putting more lights in here. I was going to do an elevator door, but a garage door, but the roof is not high enough for the garage door. It needs to be much, much higher. It's meant for a warehouse, which I do not have at the moment, so that's why I put that. And I will be closing this up as well. And then I will be putting up these for my armor. Not for my armor, for my guns and such. No. I wanted to have these, that's right. I was going to put mannequins all up because I have a lot of armor to put up. So I'm just going to put a ton of these everywhere. I'm just showing you what I'm talking about at the moment. It's not how I'm gonna have it set up, but you know, this is like literally Skyrim style. If any of you have played Skyrim before in the past, knew that you could put your gear on your mannequins, which was really, really cool. So now they brought that into Fallout. You can put your gear on your mannequins. They'll have for women and men. They have both sexes, as you can see. Female, male, female, male. So you got the hips. Wide bearing bird hips. No, put this over here. Put this back here. So these mannequins will be holding all my armor that I have collected throughout the game, which it is a lot. I have a lot of armor, so I will be doing that as well. And I will be doing a video on that. You shall be seeing it really, really soon, where I will show off everything that I've done, how I've cleaned up and put everything perfectly. So that would make a nice, nice video. I'm gonna put paintings and stuff. It's gonna look really good. So definitely subscribe so you can watch, see when that comes out, you guys can check that out. That'll be a fun video to do. Let's turn him somewhat. Pimp my armor! Believe it or not, guys, the most important thing to me out of everything in this game, for the new DLC, is the elevator. I have been desperate for an elevator since I don't know when. I have wanted one because going up and down the stairs is quite a bitch. I am tired of going up and down those stairs. Really fed up with it. So I'm actually happy that we have elevators. No more of that. So those are the mannequins. Let me go ahead and put up a wall here, so you guys can see what that was supposed to be like. Let's put the door. There you go. That's my entrance. This place, I had torn it down. It was way different from what it looks like right now. It's completely different. I'm actually going to also tear down the walls eventually and do some other stuff. That is the elevator from the outside. You can put glass, you can put regular walls, it all depends how you want it. I'm going to remove that one. And this is the section that shows for the warehouse. Go here to the walls, and we're going to go to where the glass is at. You can have broken glass, or full glass, or with the door. That is the one with the glass. I'm gonna go ahead and what's up, Ender?
Hey, Prophet?
Yep.
So, like, you know how you have the ammunition plant, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I just put some bullets into it. What is supposed to happen? Like, I'm kind of confused.
It's supposed to make bullets for you.
Yeah, like, I just put some into it. I put some .308s in it. It's, like, not doing anything.
Well, you're gonna have to add power to the machine as well.
I did.
Okay, now you're gonna have to add conveyor belts. Oh, it's, I'm not quite sure what it's gonna be, but I'm gonna be doing a lot of stuff, work on it. I'm trying to find out what it does. I haven't worked on it yet, so I have absolutely no idea how those conveyor belts and then, hoppers and all that stuff works. But it, if it works a lot like Minecraft, and I know you've played Minecraft, it's probably somewhere the same thing.
Okay.
They did do this a lot like if it was Minecraft. They did it a lot like it was Minecraft, with the hoppers and the conveyor belts. So since you have played Minecraft, you should understand it somewhat of what they're trying to do. I don't know yet because I haven't done it, but it should be something quite like that.
Right.
So that's what we have here with this armor. So this is going to be for the actual armor. And just so you guys can see what it is, I'm going to go ahead and get some armor right now. In fact, the workshop is right over here. Nice. That's this is my what I'm making is a museum to me. This is the stuff that I have done. So this is my museum, all the stuff that I'm going to have. I'm going to go ahead and get a few pieces of gear right now and see what we have. Transfer. Don't freak out, guys. I know this thing is huge. It has a lot in here. So I'm going to go ahead and let's see what we can get. Combat armor chest. combat armor left leg. Helmet. Alright, I didn't really get a full piece of gear, but as you can see, I'm gonna go ahead and go to this mannequin and use armor rack. Apparel. And obviously, you have to equip it. And that's what you get once you equip it. You have the actual armor on a mannequin. And just because I'm excited to see what it is, I have to go upstairs and get Silver Shroud. Oh, this is the wrong... Oh, I know what I did. Son of a bitch. Alright. I could just transfer from right here as well. Just transfer... And let's look for the Silver Shroud outfit. That one would actually be pretty cool to look at. All the way down. And Grognak. Grognak will also be pretty cool to put on there. Just so you guys can check that out. I wonder if he'll hold the weapon. We will find that out as well right now, guys. Kellogg's outfit. Might as well. So I'm just going to stay up. Nice. All right, let's go ahead. Silver Shroud. Mechanist armor and Mechanist helmet. Definitely something we should put on there. Miniman General's hat, General's uniform. Ideas for you guys. I'm so sorry, guys. I have a lot of shit here. I know it's sick. It's sick. I'm quite sick. I know it's a lot of stuff. Oh, I think I just followed. Silver Shroud armor, Silver Shroud hat. Now, just to see, I want to see if I can put a gun to go along with it. I'm going to see the silver. Silver submachine gun, just to check that out. I need to see. So hyped. I just got a $20 PSN card and I spent it on Monday morning. Ouch! I feel for you, bro. Are those DLC outfits? No, these are not DLC outfits. No, I can't buy that. Yeah, I know, bro. I feel for you, bro. My heart goes out to you. And the worst part is, it's only $5, man. This DLC is only $5, so I know you're dying inside. But just so you know, this is not DLC stuff. I want to put this stuff on here, so I want to check this out. Now, weapons, silver, submachine. I can't put that on there. And will it equip it? No, you cannot equip guns to the actual gear. But what you can do, I'll show you something in a minute. I'm going to take that. Let's go ahead and put in the Silver Shroud outfit. Let's go ahead and totally fucking awesome. That does look fucking cool as hell, guys. Totally, totally cool. So organized, I have to. I feel that, bro. Hey, guys, if I don't get to your comments, I'm sorry. Sometimes I don't read them because I get so into what I'm doing. Now. This is something you can do. Since you see right there, have Silver Shroud. He does have a special outfit. I'm gonna go ahead and put that should be in decorations. We're gonna go to decorations and go to display racks, and we're gonna go to the display cases. And just because it is Silver Shroud, he needs to have an awesome display rack for his gun next to him, and we're gonna give him something very, very cool. If I can get it to fit, you can't have it too far back. So, let's see how close I can get to him. I got this beta first and I loved it. Yes, definitely. So now you see that there, we're gonna go ahead and add the gun. I can't activate that way. Oh man. Okay, hopefully no one steals it. That's usually what happens. I know it happened a lot in Skyrim as well. Now we're gonna go ahead and drop the gun. The silver gun. Silver machine, drop that.
You sure we're not gonna need that?
Pete Lamb. Alright, here we go. Let's go ahead and grab this gun. Turn it and okay, that's not gonna work. So let's go ahead and do it this way. Then. And just place it right inside the case. I really would like to have it set up. But that's fine. Go ahead and close it. And now we have Silver Shroud with his silver gun right next to him. And that, my friends, is pretty freaking awesome. Now, let's go ahead and add Gragnok. Equip. And there you go. Gragnok's outfit. Pretty cool. Eventually, I'll pull the other stuff with his axe and everything. We can do that. Do you know that they are making next-gen Skyrim? Yep. I do. You can't find Deadpool online, so you... That's from school prison. Totally worth $10. So there you go. What am I going to put here? Use. Did I have anything in particular? Kellogg. Yes, that's right. Kellogg's outfit. That's Kellogg's outfit. Use this one. We're going to Mechanist Armor, Mechanist Helmet. That is fucking cool, son! Look at that shit, that's so cool, look at that. Yeah, I am so feeling this DLC, bro. So feeling this Minuteman General's hat. Guys, if you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you can be notified of all future videos, events, and live streams that come available. And I also have a ton of Fallout quality stuff. You will definitely love what you see. It's high quality videos, I swear, with the best video, best... What am I doing here? Hold on. Good commentary, good video. Really quality stuff, guys. It should make you laugh. You should love it. Now, this is pretty cool. And I'm probably going to put lighting on the floor so I can aim directly at these different mannequins. I'm going to have... This whole floor is going to be full of mannequins. It's not just it. I'm going to put a lot. Because this is going to be my little museum to me. And now, the elevator, which is my favorite part about this whole thing, is the elevator. Absolutely love the elevator. You stay down there. Sorry, Nick. Nick got left behind. And these things, these for the power armors, it is fucking phenomenal. I absolutely love this for the power armor. That looks so cool. And Dick, how the hell did you, son of a bitch, you got up here anyways? Your idea for you, new base build time lapse. Right? But they really, that would take a lot longer than I would like. It would be nice. It really would, but. With all the stuff that I do, it takes me anywhere from 5 hours to about 2 weeks to make one video. I am partnered with Machinima, and I do get paid on YouTube. I do get paid for the stuff that I do, so, you know. So the work that I put into my videos is impressive. I also, right now, I'm currently making a web series. I'm on episode number 7 that I'm currently making, but I've already done 6. It's Tournament Arena Battle Droids, where I take friends and people that I know, streamers, and I make robots out of them. And I have their faces, and I have their arm, their robots, and every episode is a different robot fighting. Which is awesome. Yes, these, I did steal these frames from the BOS, and I'll just put different stuff on them. And I fight the robots. I also have another one with Pleatherface and the Pleather Dome. Those are a lot of fun. Let me go ahead and move these forward. So you guys should definitely check those out, man. They're really, really great videos. You will laugh a lot. A lot of them are really funny. The stuff that I do, the stuff that I say. Have a riot, sir. Not a movies. I still need to get another power armor from... Oh, that's right. If you leave the power armor close enough to the casing, it will automatically suck it in and just put it in, so you don't have to actually grab it. Like, these were over here, and as I activated it, just sucked in the power arm and put it in there. So that was pretty cool. Yeah, 817. I know I should have more, or whatever, but it happens, you know. You gotta start somewhere. It's a lot of work. People tell me that, I'm like, why do you don't have enough views? I know. But I've only been doing this for about a year and a half? No, 2 years, sorry, 2 years. I've only been doing this for about 2 years, so I don't have the millions of subs and the millions of views on my videos like other people do. But eventually people will take notice and I will have those huge amounts. At the moment, I'm still starting pretty much. Oh, 2 years is still starting, believe it or not. It's a lot of work.
I just realized yesterday I uploaded like 450 videos.
You do? You got four?
It's ridiculous. Like, if you look
no
at
doubt,
them,
Spartan.
Half of them,
no doubt, bro. No doubt.
Half of them are just like flat out stupid.
Yeah. Guys, I will be doing Skyrim videos, a lot of them also, when I finally do. I will be doing a shit ton of Skyrim videos because I did put another 700 hours into Skyrim when I was playing it before. Do we really? Ah, yeah, kind of. But mine has the Earth in it. Look at the picture. I edited the video, the picture, and put the actual Earth that's on fire in it, and I put my name in the word, so it's almost the same. It's real close. Good eye though. It's pretty awesome. Eventually I will make my own background, like hardcore style, like really, really quality shit. I need to move this farther up. I was streaming earlier today. No doubt. No doubt. Let me move these somewhat more forward. Yep. But like I was saying, I was streaming earlier today. Far Harbor DLC. Yeah, it was something like that. And believe it or not, when you're streaming, if you wanna, what's up, Mikey? If you wanna do a good quality thing and you wanna grow your channel, it's best to make your videos, your streams, anywhere from 8 to 12 hours long, and only once in a blue do 4-hour streams. That's if you're trying to grow your channel as a streamer. That is, you have to look at it as a job, because that's what it is. It's your job. So when you're trying to grow your channel as a streaming channel, that's the best thing you can do for your channel. I just do tubing. I just make the YouTube videos mostly. So I stream once in a blue. And I do enjoy it. I'm not going to lie. I love streaming. But mostly what I do is make videos. So that's why you'll see more videos than anything on my channel. Let's go ahead and put some power armors in here. You know what? Because we are doing this, I'm going to check and see what kind of things these do, if maybe the colors change or anything. What's up, Landacon? So we're going to try out the other power armor stations and see if maybe they might have colored lights in them. If any, we'll see. Yeah, that would have to be, if you want to go where you can constantly switch games, you would definitely need to go onto PC. That is the best thing you could possibly do for that. If you like switching games when you're streaming, you definitely want to go PC. Not saying play your games on PC, but have your PlayStation connected directly to your PC via OBS or Elgato or one of your other streaming services. That way it won't cut off your gaming. If not, it will, and that kind of defeats the purpose if you're switching games. Actually, I like that way, the way that looks with different colors. So that side is all normal and this side is with colors. Okay, we're gonna do that. We're gonna switch between them and see how that looks. We're gonna do variations of colors. We're going to remove this one and we're going to fix this one because they do turn. If any of you have had that issue before where you use the light boxes and they start to turn, well, these are similar to that. I've already seen as I was working that they do turn, so you're gonna have to constantly fix them so they don't turn. How much did this turn here? Actually, this didn't turn too much, but we still need to remember that one's red. Yeah, but I don't want to go RSID PC. No, I'm not saying buy a PC. It's like if you have it connected to a PC, you can stream a lot easier. Like I use it to my laptop, and sometimes I stream through Twitch or one of the other services on my PC and just stream live from there, and it's not bad. It's actually pretty decent, and then you can switch between your games and all that stuff, and you won't have to stop your stream. Use a damn RAM. A ramp? You're talking about me? Okay, those are good to go. Now we can actually go ahead and move this in here as well. And here we go. Let's go ahead and put the switches. There we go. Okay, that's gonna be a little bit difficult. Move this more forward. And we're going to try and turn this one somewhat to the corner, which should help. Now we can grab this cable and connect it directly to there. And we're good to go. Of course, as all of you know, whoever's here would walk through that cable and die. Dead. And now we can put the other one over here. Put it right there. It should go right through, which is good. And now we can start connecting these things. There we go. Okay, the light boxes are not changing colors, which is okay. So now we do. You should check out some of my videos tomorrow. I'll try, yeah, definitely. What can you build in the new DLC? You're gonna check it out, you're gonna see. I'm trying to build as much as possible. Today I'm gonna stream for about 4 hours today, showing off all the stuff that you can possibly do. I'm trying to get as much as possible today before tomorrow. We'll also be streaming if I wake up, because I'm gonna be on here late. So that's what that looks like. And now check this out. What I was telling you before, this will literally suck as soon as you activate it. It will suck the power armor that's closest to it and put it right into it. Okay, so that one's not gonna grab that one. That's fine. There it goes. See how it does it? Just sucks it right in. As you activate them, which is, I feel so Iron Man right now, Tony Stark. I don't have to do anything. Just grabs it, puts it in. Nice. Very nice. Okay, that one's not gonna work there. Come on, come on, come on. Is it because it's stolen? Oh, don't play with me like that. Oh, I was gonna say. Normally I would have my face, I would have the cam on because I want you to get the full feel of the entire video. Bro, Spartan, you have to start somewhere, bro. I started with shit videos too, man. You don't just make the best stuff right off the rip. It takes a while. It takes some real work, but eventually you will. And I lost what I was saying. Barely tell us apart. And there you go. Oh, perfect. Not to need to move this one as well.
Something about YouTube you have to know is that you can never give up on your channel. Ever.
Oh yeah, never give up on your channel, bro. On YouTube, just constantly work on it. Constantly work, man. It's rough. It can be discouraging. I know I've been there plenty of times. It does get discouraging, but all you can do is just keep working at it. Keep working, keep working, keep working. Do the videos. Don't do it for the money. Do it because you enjoy it. If you're doing it because you have fun, bro, your channel is definitely gonna work for you. But if you're doing it for the money, bro, you're gonna get way more discouraged. Do it because you love doing it. Do it because you have fun. Do it because you just want to do it. If you do it that way, you should have no problem. And your channel should grow. You should get other people. Also, socialize. Socialize, socialize, socialize. That is really, really important. Get on Twitter. Get on all the social networks and socialize. It will do nothing but help your channel. And don't do sub for sub, because if you do sub for sub, people aren't going to watch your videos. They're just subscribing to you, and subs don't make you money anyways and don't get you views. Subs are just there. You want people who are going to watch your videos. So get socialize with people on Twitter about stuff that you like.
And don't ever let hate get to you if people comment stuff on your videos.
Yeah. Yeah, don't let that stuff bother you either. Yeah, definitely. Don't let people talking shit bother you, because it comes with the territory. It just, people are just like that. It's going to happen. Don't let it bother you. That looks really, really cool, man. I am loving the way that looks. I almost didn't got Dying Light and met another YouTuber. Cool. I have a video worth over. Nice. That is awesome. 100,000 viewer video. That is fucking great, bro. That is really good. Oh, check it out. I actually like the way that looks. But just because I am who I am, I am going to have to go show you real quick and go to the other map, the other settlements, and go get another power armor. We're going to go to Spectacle Island so you guys can see what I have there. It's just another one of the builds that I have in here that eventually I will be working on as well with all the DLC stuff that we have. That is another huge, huge, huge build that I have. So you should like that one. I haven't gotten a hater yet. I'm kind of on edge. Bro, you will, man. You will. They always come, bro. The more popular your video is, or the more popular you are, the more haters you will get. That is, yes, that is like a level up. Level up. Haters come and go. But the quality of videos will show you are.
Trying to kill us, but
Piper, move.
Commonwealth never lacks for
this is another build that I have. In Spectacle Island. This one is huge. I have a lot of robots. I have a lot of stuff here. This one is... See, I have a shit ton of power armor everywhere, as you can see. I have a lot of power armor. So... I should get one of these rock ones with the rockets on it. It says a rocket on it? Let me see. That one looks like it has a rocket on it. It's BOS. Oh, yeah, my skills, level up. Yeah. I always forget about that. I know I put it on perception today. Or... No, I put it here because I wanted this thing. Thank you, sir. Much obliged. Now, you see, I have a lot of power armor, bro. A lot of power armor. This is one of my builds, my tournament arenas. As you can see, I have it full. And I'll pull this, and everybody will come here. I have a bunch of robots down there. But let's go ahead and take one of these power armors back to... These are not good. So bad. That is cool, man. That is really cool. Like when I flip these switches, it will literally open up the cages, and I'll have all the robots that are sitting here, and they'll fight. See, I have more power armor here going down this building. I have power armor everywhere, bro. Everywhere. I'm actually, I haven't finished the game yet, not once. I'm still on my first playthrough. Over 700 hours in, and I'm still on my very first playthrough. I have not moved on. Robots. See, the robots are here. Each one of these holds a robot, and when I pull the switch, they start fighting, and we have a war going on up front. Something came on here. All right, put that away.
Can't wait to get out of this goddamn heat. Farming's as honest as honest work.
There you go.
I can't remember the last time I had clean fingers.
Yeah, man, bro, it's. This is a power. It's crazy. I wired the shit out of this place. I have a few variations of this build. What is he doing in there? These are my my magazines. I'm going to be moving this back to my other build. I'm definitely taking this back over there. I have power armor stations here like crazy. I don't really use this place much. Just for when I'm doing tournaments. I might as well go ahead and let you guys see what it looks like from the outside. Only fitting. Let's wait till the daytime. This used to be the lion's den. If you guys check that out. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you check out my Lion's Den video on YouTube, it was an awesome build. One of the first builds to use the lions on the outside. And I get copied a lot. That's one thing I do. I get copied a lot because people know my builds. And but it's okay. I don't really bother me. Just prefer to get credit for stuff. And this is the Lion's Den. Well, it used to be. Now it's just a battle arena. And this is the size, the massive size of this creature. Down to take one of these power armors and fit that back over there. Don't really know which one I want to take, so I'll just go over here and get one of these. What do you mean possible target in range? Oh, see, there's the robots right there. They're gonna go fight something. They saw something. There's something inside. There it is down there. I see it. You guys seriously need to move. Holy shit, a freaking Jaguar. I hate when they actually get in here. Alright, cool. Alright. Now let's go get a power armor. I'm going to take one of these because they look like they have rockets on them. I don't know. Alright, here we go. Oh, I've been playing since... Sorry, I haven't been reading. I'm sorry. Because I wear power armor. Funny to spawn. Did you give me some... Well, I've been playing this game, like I said, since day one, 700 hours. And I used to make a lot of stuff to make water. And I would sell all that water and I would wait days, like do a lot of waiting. And I would wait from day to day to get to sell them. So I would wait 48 hours, sell the water, buy all the ammo, buy all the resources, and then... I would sell more water, and then I would get all the money back, make sure I had everything, then I would go ahead again and wait another 48 hours and do the same thing. So that's pretty much what I would do a lot. And then after a while, I started to notice that even though I had a shit ton of resources, it was starting to get really bad, that I needed more, and it was getting harder and harder to find. So then I started doing a little bit of glitching just for some resources, and then I was good. Thanks, man. Yeah, I've been told that too, that I make people want to play Fallout with the stuff that I do, the builds that I make, the creations that I have. I have another one, another build. I should have showed that one to you guys. Sanctuary Hills. No, sorry, Spectacle Island. The Spectacle Island build. That one is pretty awesome. That one is a huge arena that I have for fighting monsters and stuff like that, and creatures. That one is a lot of fun. Now I'm going to go ahead and leave this power armor right here. And I just click here. There it is. Now take my fusion core back. And there you go. Only thing is I have two Atom Cats here. That's all right. That actually looks pretty cool, man. I like how that looks. I really, really, really like that. I like that part of the DLC. This was probably one of the best things for me, personally, because I'm a collector. I'm ecstatic about what they did with this. Like, I'm really, really happy. This is so cool, bro. So cool. Now, we're going to do some other checking because we need to. We're going to go ahead and go upstairs to the third floor. There's another thing that's part of the DLC, the elevator. Damn, Nick. You're gonna kill yourself. This is the third floor, and what we're gonna be doing in the third floor is walls. We're gonna be putting a lot of walls because I want to have guns.
That's what I just did. Looks awesome.
Yeah, I collect everything, but I don't sell any of this. I have a sick fascination with not selling anything, and I have massive amounts of stuff, bro. Tyler, I would love to use the ball tracks right now, but I've been showing people what I'm doing with this build. That will probably be for tomorrow's stream, or maybe later on tonight. Remember, I'm going to be on for 4 hours tonight. I've already been on since 12, so... all depends on what I can get to. I'm pretty much not doing a full-on everything. I'm just doing bits and pieces here and there of things that I can do. So this is a short wall. This is actually good that this is a short wall, because I can actually put this all the way across and use it as a museum type wall and put guns on it and have a nice setup. That would actually look really, really cool. So we're gonna put, not now, but we're gonna go show what we can do here. Decorations. we're going to go to displays. Is it displays? Not these displays. The gun racks suck. Really?
Whoa. Hey, Prophet.
Yeah.
There's these things that you can get for the firework launchers, right? And it changes the weather.
Yeah, yeah, I know. I saw that one. I saw a video of that. So this is the heavy. We're going to go ahead and put that right there. For heavy weapons. The displays, I wasn't impressed with some of the displays because we went, is weapon rack short, weapon rack long, pistol rack, weapon rack, weapon rack. What's this look like? All the way around, this one is different. Okay, let's try a weapon rack long. We're gonna put a few of these up against the wall, way up at the top. They do clip. They do clip, guys. That's a good thing. That is good. I like that they do clip. That is a must. That is a huge plus. But this one doesn't clip. Let me see if... they clip in that manner. Each have their own way of clipping. Okay. Pistol. Let's display one single weapon. This is to so that's what we have there. I should go ahead and put another long one and another short just to fill up the wall. And why should we do that, guys? Because we can. Because we can. They should have a snap mode where you can turn it off and on. I believe you're right about that one. Okay, this is for the heavy weapon stand. I'm not too enthusiastic. I'm not too enthusiastic about that. There you go. So that's for a display, a single medium-sized weapon. And this is pistol, medium-sized weapon. Believe it or not, I like these better than the chained ones, but we can move those over. So that should look pretty cool. Put those there like that. And we'll do something similar to this, but on the other side with the ones we just had. We'll use these. That's what that's gonna look like. Now we're gonna need weapons. We're gonna need weapons so we can add them to this display. We're gonna have this whole room is gonna be filled with nothing but weapons. And we're gonna need display cases as well. The display cases, oh, mods is gonna be sick. Sick, sick, sick. These display cases are pretty much gonna be for my more favorite pieces. some more. This is for my trophy guns and weapons. None of this is set in stone at the moment, guys. This is just me putting stuff down, testing it out. But none of this will be set in stone. I will be changing all of this. I'm just putting it down because I want to test everything out and see what we can do here, how things look. It's not gonna work there too well, so we'll just go ahead and put it right there. Or hold up. But these are to display your weapons. These are a lot like Skyrim, that you put them there and just leave them. It's activated. Okay, so they open through the front door. Okay. These, you literally have to drop the weapons in it. It's not like you can just activate it like before. These have to drop it right into it and then close the glass. But knowing how things have happened in the past, I do have some ideas for the tracks, but knowing how things went in Skyrim, more than likely these things will probably end up falling out. But we'll just have to see about that and see how that goes. Now, we're going to go get some guns. And, they're in the third floor, right? Oh, I'm on the third floor. If I put a... Oh, wow, that was the glitch you had? Yeah, that one would have really sucked. Okay, let's transfer some weapons from here and see what happens. Okay, let's go ahead and take this, the fish catcher. The big boy, the bloody baseball bat, Cavalier Shish Kebab. I gotta put the Cryolator, Death Claw Gauntlet, Deliverer, Enraging Fat Man, the Experimental MRV, Exterminator's Rifle. Gotta put some knuckles, definitely. Gatlin laser gun, General Cho's revenge. We'll take one of these. Good intentions. Irradiated minigun. I put a Deirdre weapon in the case. I can't wait until 8 so I can get on the Xbox and blah. Let's take this, the junk jet, let's take that, the junkies ripper, Kellogg's pistol, definitely gotta take that. This, we gotta take that. Lorenzo's artifact gun. The flamer, let's take one of those. Pikmin's blade. Oh, I'm gonna build a factory. You better believe it, bro. That's gonna be one of the things I'm gonna be doing next. Railway rifle. We gotta take one of those. Reba. Excuse me. The revolutionary sword. Righteous authority. Spray and pray. Let's go take that one. The sniper Gauss rifle. The Zeta gun. Alright, for now, that's good. Let's go ahead and check this stuff out. Oh, I'm going to make a huge, huge factory. That's for damn sure. Bro, I love the elevator, bro. All right, here we go. We're going to
transfer. Elevator's OP.
Yeah, bro, the elevator is the shit. Let's put something big on here. There we go, big boy. And just like that. Okay, it sets itself. I like that. It'll set itself depending on what you put in it. Okay. Let's put something else on here. Cryolator. What? That can't go there? Why? That sucks.
I'm almost to the very top of the elevator.
Yeah. Where did you get the action rifle? Believe it or not, I have no idea. Bro, I don't know, remember half of the stuff where I got them from.
I probably will.
You probably will. Yeah, you can't put the cryolator on one of these things here, man. Experiment.
You have to put it on a heavy thing.
Yeah, I put it on the heavy. It wouldn't sit there.
Wow, that's weird.
Yeah, I know. Gatling laser. Sensor. My brother was gonna have go nuts with this. Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need little lights connected to these so I can light up. Put one more. I know, right? You can put a minigun on it, but you can't put the cryolator. That's funny. Okay, let's go ahead and put the flamer on there. Nocturnal flamer. I wonder. Let's see something. You can see the bangles. That's pretty cool. You can pick it up with the weapon on it and still move it around. That's pretty cool. And put it in the direction you want. That, I like that. I like that a lot. So you can go ahead and move it around and put it how you want it. It's pretty decent. You don't have to actually take it off and be like, oh man, I screwed up. I don't want it there. You can take it off. No, you can just put it as is. I like these toys because they have lines, the crease lines, and it just helps for you to use them and put stuff on. Maybe too long mod. It could, you know what? That mod could be it. That long mod that I have on it could be a problem. That could be why it won't sit on it. You're probably right. I'm definitely gonna have to put the weapon crafter up here. That way to make things a lot easier when I want to put things up here and stuff. Because I'm going to literally have one of every single gun up here. Of every kind. This is my weapons museum up here.
Prophet, if you saw the security that is in the main entrance of this base, you'd just be like, really? Like, there's just way too much. Like, there's like 12 turns facing one small door.
Yo, Dean, believe it or not, I do use the fusion cores, bro. I've just bought so many. It's hard to use them all. It's hard to get rid of them. I've tried. But I usually use them on the power armors. I don't use it on the mini laser. I don't use it on the laser. So I it's hard to waste them. But I'm always using in the power armor. I'm always in a power armor, so... Okay, so that's that. I moved those. Those look good there. Okay, cool. Now, we want to actually transfer here. See what it says. Will it allow that? No. Okay, good. So it will let you know that you can't put stuff like that on there. Can I put that? That will go on. So let's see what that looks like. That is tiny. And you can just take it right off of her. Retransfer. How many things can you put on? Now we're going to find that out as well. How many different things can we put on there? Is it just for one? Ah, there you go. You can only put one. See, I figured that much. Cool. Just had to check it out. Let's put all the little small stuff over here for now. I like it, bro. I'm like ecstatic about this, bro. This is freaking awesome.
I'm probably gonna try to build a conveyor belt thing next.
You can't even see that little thing I put on there. Can't put pigments blend on there, really? Yeah, I figured that much. No, that's mine. I figured Kellogg's pistol. I should be able to go on the wall. Yep. Okay, cool. Now the long ones. Let's transfer these. The action rifle should be able to go up. Okay, cool. The Admiral's friend should be able to go up on the wall. No, it does not. It's too big. Assaultron blade? Yes. The Assaultron blade will go. No, those are the ones I'm keeping. The fish catcher? Yes, the fish catcher will go on the wall. Okay. Transfer. That's mine. These are mine. Okay, bloody bat. That will also go on the wall. It's kind of small. Some of these are kind of small.
Hard to not let it get to you sometimes.
If I'm able to put them... Let's also test this theory out. Okay, then yes. You can stack them on each other and save space. If you see something is too small, you can put these on top of each other. Perfect. I like that. Good. That'll help save on space and won't look too bad. But some of these clamping to each other is not good. That is, I already saw a glitch with that one. I saw it clamped to each other. That shouldn't have done that. A permanent clamp shouldn't have done that. Back to small stuff again. It's fucking cool. You can even put a boxing glove up there on the wall. I was just checking to see if I could put the cry later. Oh! The death claw. Oh, that looks actually cool up there. I didn't think that was going to sit up there well. Will this one fit on there? No, I didn't think so. Good intentions? No. Chunk chat? No. Junkies Ripper? No. No. We'll put that Lorenzo's artifact gun.
Prophet, you gotta check out that junk mortar. I think it's awesome.
The junk mortar? Oh, yeah. So that's okay. Now let's go ahead and put, see what we can do with these. Admirals will not go. Oh, don't I have another one? No, that won't go up there either. Yeah, I'm liking what I can do here. Yeah, I will definitely show you the elevator in just a minute. I'm just trying to put this stuff up here. That is actually pretty cool. I like that. I also like the fact that you can stack them on each other. These won't stack though. These right here will not stack. So you need to be careful. They stack side to side. You can't actually put them on each other. These you can though. If you want to have things on top of each other, you can stack these, move them over, and you can have it just like that and it'll still stay. So that's pretty cool. See, like that? That would look awesome there. So stacking is definitely something cool. These won't stack in that way though. Oh, I was wrong. Let me shut up. Look, they do. You can move them together. You can stack them over each other. And that is also something that's pretty cool. I like that. Okay. Okay. Shut me up quick, didn't you? Yes, you did. Okay, so now we wanted to actually put some stuff in these as well and see what's up with that. So for this one, I actually have to drop something on the ground. So go ahead and try and set this up. there you go. The Admiral's Fiend is in there, no problem. Let's go ahead and drop another one. The Cryolator. Okay, that one doesn't want to work that way. Cryolator is all moving funny. Alright, let's try something. If I was to grab it this way, if it would allow me to sit it there, or would it... No, it won't work that way. But... No. Oh, the action. Okay. Now I know which one's talking about. Perfect. The action right here. Okay. So there we go. We already have two of these in here. That's actually pretty cool that I can do that. Hopefully they don't get lost or someone steals them from me, like one of the settlers, because then I'm going to go butt wild. I'm going to kill everybody in the town. The jink jet is huge. Is it? Okay, that one. Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, that is Far Harbor. I forgot where I got that. I think I bought it from one of the vendors. There you go. I bought that one from one of the vendors. I think it was like 10,000, something like that. Bro, that actually is pretty cool to have that in there. I prefer to have that though, more visible, like one of these. Now, let's see what else we can put in one of these cases. Pikmin's Blade. I bet. Pikmin's Blade. It seems to be a huge shame to have to put such a small knife. It's such a big case. It would have been nice if inside these cases they would have had like red cushion or something. That way these things could be more visible. Drop the spray and pray. So you're definitely going to need lighting from the top, or it all depends on how much stim packs you really use and what level you're playing the game. I have so many that I couldn't even tell you, but I use on an average on a mission, on a hard mission, I'll use on an average about 20, well, anywhere from 10 to 20 stim packs, depending on what I meet up at the moment. Let me see, can you put some lights on these? We're going to find that out right now, directly on these things. Can you put lighting on the cases? Water's good too, man. Actually, that is not bad, but would it be better in the back? Okay. Oh, no.
I've been told the Valentine Detective Agency signs are an eye.
Holy shit, I already lost the gun.
But they sure bring in the business.
Look at it. So now you know you cannot move the display cases with the guns in them. Not these. You can move the other ones, but not these. You will lose a weapon. So that, I can tell you right now, is going to be horror. Pay attention to when you do this. You could lose a lot of stuff with these cases. Letting you know as of right now, I already saw what could be a terror. And if you have some really amazing weapons that you have, don't be that person. You can, like I'm doing right now, quite possibly a huge chance to lose this weapon. And it's one of my favorite guns. One of my more favorite guns. There you go. Well, this little light here is not that great. Let me go ahead and try one of the other lights. See what else would be... This one would be good. It's actually pretty good. Pretty good. Nah, you didn't show up late, man. You showed up just in time, bro. Because now you get to see all the stuff together. Let's see, what other lights could be good for this? This one, this is too big. Good lord, that is bright. But, it helps for both things, actually. No, that light is way too bright for this one thing here. Let's see. Ah, track lights. Track lights are perfect for this. Yep, track lighting. No, don't take the roof. Okay. Is that track lighting still brightening up the whole thing over there? Jesus. Those track lights are strong, huh? Well, that's actually pretty cool, though. I like the... That would be better if it was actually right there. Does not work well there. And then here there's these little tiny spotlights. You have to actually pay attention to where you put them. See how well these little tiny spotlights... Oh, that one's not even on. No wonder. Okay, so that's not going to work there. Because I don't have any power running there yet. But actually these track lights, these cases can actually be pretty good. Depending on where you put track lighting and stuff. So that's pretty decent. Decent. Yeah, it was a cool magic trick. Let's go ahead and do some quick lighting for these then. Since we do have track lighting, might as well. hell of a shovel. Nice little museum style track lights. Bro, it's been a lot of work, man. I've had to do a lot of work to get all these resources. That actually looks really good. That with the track lighting there, I'm quite impressed. It works well with each other. The DLCs do work well with each other. I have a video on YouTube, my channel, that tells you, sorry, I'm cracking my neck, that tells you how to make money in this game and how to get resources and stuff like that, where to find the resources. My videos are very useful, trust me, they help a lot. That's pretty cool. I like it. So this will be the weapons museum. And now let's go ahead and go back downstairs to the first floor real quick. This is the elevator, guys. We're gonna go outside so you can see from outside as well. The elevator is awesome. I fucking love the elevator. These are the mannequins. There are some cool ideas for you guys. If you guys want to get an idea of how much stuff I have in this game, check this out. This is a good idea. Now watch. You can go ahead and count and see how long it takes you to get from here to the bottom. But start counting. As you can see, it is a lot of stuff. This is everything I have in my workshop. This is how much stuff I've collected, how much stuff I have. And I still have the other workshops in the other places. And we're still rifling through this whole thing. We're just in the seas. Oh, the elevator takes a lot of resources, man. Like, as you can see, guys, what I'm going to be doing with the... this museum that I have here is going to be a lot. I have a lot of stuff to add and a lot of stuff to put in there. So I'm going to be taking a lot of time to do this. But it should, in the end, be quite impressive. It should be awesome. You can put toys in the cases, not just weapons. You can put toys in those cases, display your toys, display items you've had. It's a museum. It's pretty much whatever you want to do. You can even put sodas in there. Nuka-Colas, Nuka-Quantums, whatever you want, vodkas, all, however you decide, however you think, you can, it's just pretty much use your imagination. You can even put bones in there if you want, meat, food, however you want, use your imagination, guys. I would love to see if you guys have videos and you send us, I'd love to check out your stuff if you actually make stuff. I wouldn't mind. See, we're still going, just so you know how much stuff I have in my workshop, and I was not lying to you guys, this is a lot of stuff. We're still going, aren't we? I think we're almost done now. There we go. We finally finished. Ooh, Zeke's. So there you go, guys. Yep. So yeah, I have a lot of stuff, as you guys just saw. Because people just usually, when they cheese... or they cheat a game, it'll usually just be materials. But when you see somebody who has that much of everything, that's not just from cheesing. That's from a person who's been playing his ass off for a long time. So these are the different parts. I'm going to be putting mannequins like... This whole thing is going to be filled. Yeah, right, Echo? So I'm going to have this whole place filled with mannequins, wall-to-wall mannequins, showing off all my armors, and I'm having display cases here in the center. I'm going to have a lot of stuff. I'm going to put paintings on the wall just to give it that extra feel. In fact, I didn't check to see if they added new paintings.
No, they didn't.
No?
Literally just checked.
Oh, man. That sucks. Wait, no. Look. Yes, posters.
Oh, yeah, the posters. Yeah,
yeah, they have posters. And I think you can connect. Yeah, you can power them and they'll light up. Oh, I like it. Yeah, if you put connected to with power. Yep, this place is definitely going to be pretty awesome. How many posters do we have? Quite a few. So fucking excited. Fuck me, baby. Oh, this is too freaking awesome, man. Different types of frames. I saw there was a different type of frame. Look at that. Yeah, this one is round edges. Factory. Conveyor belt. Oh, this is too freaking awesome, bro. Let's see, do they have any more? No, they have two different types of frames. But all these paintings, half of them is from one side, half of the other. Teddy bears. Yeah, I really want to see them conveyor belts, huh? Any new flags? Nope, no new flags. Statues? No. See, they should have given us statues. What's up, defective, bro? How you doing, big dog? As you can see, yes, I'm still awake. I am still awake, showing off all the cool stuff here in Fallout. Which is, honestly, they have a lot of really neat, cool things in this new DLC. Like, I'm quite impressed, really. Really, really impressed with what they've put in.
I'll be completely honest. I don't know how I didn't pass out already.
For real?
Yeah, I don't know how I haven't. I've been sitting here just minding my own business for, like, the last hour. I'm sorry, I'm weird when I'm tired. If we want to win the...
Can you link a builder directly to workshop junk? A settler? More than likely you can. Now, for those of you just joining, this is the elevator that I... Oh, yes, I was going to show you guys from the outside.
There's no
the elevator. And I'm going to show you how many resources it takes and what size elevators. That is a four-story elevator. The glass I put out myself. But here we go. Check this out. This is the elevator. Let's go to the elevator. You see power. Bro, I always lose the elevator. Where's the elevator at? Structures. There it is. In structures. This is the elevator. This is the two-story one. See it? There's the bare bones. This is what it looks like normally. Now, as you can see, it takes 16 steel, 2 copper, 4 wood, 3 gear, and 2 circuitry. Now we're going to the... there's not much change in the 2 to 3 floor. But when you go to the 4 floor, that's it right there. It's might as well go ahead and put another one. I'm going to be using it again later. That's what it looks like. Bare bones. And then you can go ahead and take these structure right here. Go to warehouse. And go to this one and add the walls. The walls go to about the right size to it. However you want. I liked these. I put the glass on it. You can see. You can close off all sides, or you can use this one. This side would have Why is this guy trying to go to the damn thing? See, this side would have the button on this side and the button on this side, so you can call the elevator from either side. Or you could just close it off. Or you could just make it an entrance. You see there? One side could just be the entrance and this side could be the one to the call, however you want. Or not have any button calls at all. It's all on you. However you want, of course. I know, guys, I'm just wasting materials left and right, but honestly, I have so many of them, it doesn't really faze me. And this one, you can close it off. And you can continue to do that all the way to the top. And you can keep doing that, and that's how you make the elevator. It will cost a lot of resources. factory. Alright, guys, we're gonna build a factory. Let's build a factory. You guys wanna see a factory? I know you wanna see a factory. Give me a second. I'm gonna put the comments on the screen because it's hard to look at the computer while I'm doing this. I wasn't gonna do that, but I'm gonna give me 1 second so I can put the comments on the screen so I can see those. Advanced settings, display message to spectators. Okay, that should be good. There you go. Everybody type factory, gotta pick up and drop. As if I'm not addictive enough. Yes, exactly. For real. Then I go ahead and do something like that. Now, there we go. This is here. And that's the elevator. The four-story elevator. It's freaking beautiful. Now, since if you guys haven't seen, we're going to go ahead and go inside real quick into the elevator and press every button. See, this is the call button. We're going to go to 4-2. This is probably one of my... Well, this is my favorite floor in the place because of these power armor displays. You can put displays for power armors now.
Hey, you mind keeping an eye?
Yes, you can produce ammo. There is for production of ammo.
Thanks.
This is the power armor display cases, which are fucking beautiful. I absolutely love this. This is my favorite room in this so far now. So I'm like ecstatic about this. I made all these just one color, and then I went ahead and put these with color just to switch it. No, you cannot mine. I don't know. We're gonna go find out, guys. We're literally gonna go find out now. I'm gonna go build a quick factory just so we can test that out, and we're gonna see what's up. Let's go fourth floor. This is the fourth floor, the top deck. Pretty cool. We're gonna find out, bro. Echo, we are gonna find out. I have no idea. I haven't done this yet. This is my first run through. I'm also learning. We're learning together. We're all learning together, guys. This is also my first try playing this DLC. It just dropped at 12 o'clock. And I've built everything you see now. I built while I was doing this. Yeah, in the Vault DLC, yes. And this is for any of you who haven't seen this already. This is where you stack your weapons. This is what it would look like. Yeah, but I promised a 4-hour stream and I'm trying to work with that and do that. I know I'm tired. I haven't had much sleep today since I was streaming earlier as well. But I wanted to do this. But I love this room.
Give me a laser rifle and my power.
This room is too awesome. No mini nukes? Well, that's a damn shame. I used to have stairs all up and down this building. In fact, it was, this building was about right here. It was cut off right here. And I added more stuff today. Since I knew everything that was coming out on the DLC today, I pretty much added and cut out the stairs and everything. So that way I could put an elevator, because that was probably the most important thing to me, was the elevator, which I was desperate to have. And I'm going to put a few, I'm going to change around that hotel over there. I'm going to change it around as well. And I'm going to go start doing the factory over here. I'm not, like you guys said, I'm not going to build anything sophisticated right now. I'm going to make a simple factory. Nothing major.
Which isn't simple.
Yeah.
Dude, it's hard to make a factory. I was looking at it for like an hour, and I'm just like, nope.
Okay, we're going to try and use the DLC stuff. Well, here we go. This is where profit gets crazy. Factory floors, here we go. For those of you joining me right now, we are going to build a factory with this new DLC. This is my first run through. We're all learning together. So I hope you enjoy it. Guys, for everyone who hasn't already, please subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much, everyone, for watching right now. This is awesome. You guys are being great. I have a lot, I do a lot of builds, a lot of crazy builds, huge, huge monster builds, great commentary, good quality video. I try to keep it as entertaining as possible. I like this floor. This factory floor is actually pretty decent. But let's go ahead and extend it just to one more. Because Prophet can't just do little. He can't help himself. Okay, now let's make a factory wall. Let's get rid of these. Don't need these anymore. Let's remove that. Let's hopefully nobody tries to come in here. Okay, here we go. Let's go ahead and put some factory walls, warehouse walls. But I think it'd be really cool if we got some with windows so we can see a lot more and not be blocked off. So we're going to go ahead and put with windows. The glass is bulletproof. I've already seen it. You cannot shoot through the glass, which is quite funny, really. But what the hell is that still doing there? Gonna make a huge factory, like ridiculously huge. But it's gonna be small. Yeah, it's gonna be small, but it's gonna be huge. So yeah, guys, it's gonna be small, but it's gonna be huge. So yeah. So much for that. We're gonna put
Good luck with that, man.
Yeah,
it's
right?
Hard to do.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. I couldn't figure it out. I was looking at it for a decent amount of time, like an hour.
As you said.
Not gonna lie, if you get it, I'm gonna feel brain dead, retarded.
Bro, so, but I mean,
don't get it. I'm just kidding.
don't get upset, because remember, I usually figure this shit out. This stuff is not hard. I mean, you saw what I did with that DLC the other day in Far Harbor. Went through that puzzle like it was nothing. Alright, so... Yep.
And, don't even want to get into how hard that was for me.
Okay, let's go ahead and put some... We want to do... You know what? Let's put a scaffolding right here in the center of the room so we can get up to the top. That way I can just build to it. Will it let me? Will it not? I think it's too high. Yep, that's what it was. It was too high. So let's go to this one. And is this one too high as well? No. Okay, cool. Let's put that there. Alright. We'll just put some scaffolding up. Now we can work. Cool. I can work from different angles here. Okay. Wish at least we had some story layer DLC, just more workshop stuff. Yeah, I know, Jacob, but there's a lot of people like me who really, really love building. So most of the people right now playing Fallout, believe it or not, most people are building. But that's why it's just been that one DLC, Far Harbor, that's been story-oriented, and the Nuka World. Ooh, work. Yes. Work, 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 the whole day through. I'm gonna work, 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 because that's what we do. Alright, let's put some more windows. Cool, I do that, huh? No shit. Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that. Factory is way bigger than I was hoping it to be, but whatever, that's fine. Let's put a steam on that you download. That's pretty fucked up, man. All right, let's go ahead and put some roof stuff on here. Let's see if this will work for us like this. That is really fucked up. Yeah, I know, right? So how much can you clip onto the roof? No, once it's there, it's there. Okay. You can continue to clip onto. Or maybe we can. Maybe I'm just too high. It's more than likely I'm too high already. But we'll find out from down here if you can clip from... No, you still can't clip to it like that. We have these. I can do a flat roof. Yeah. Oh, look at that. Okay. That'll work. We just tested that out real quick. Let's go ahead and go upstairs and clip that to that. And we're going to give it a corner roof right here, which I saw you could have. Go ahead and put that on there. Perfect. Nice. Very, very nice. Building a factory. Building a factory. We're building a factory in a factory. Let's build a factory. Nope, nope. Come on. Now let's put that. Oh, that doesn't belong there. Gotta put the corner piece. Perfect. Now let's step back for a minute. Check out our progress. That, wow, that looks pretty fucking cool, actually. Damn, alright. Not bad. Yeah, right? Don't we all, that feeling when it actually snaps together, it just works perfectly, we have to deal with stuff. Wait, I don't want this one. I have to move the scaffolding over, huh? Okay, can't go that far. That needed to be a corner.
If oh, yeah, you can't, I don't know,
download,
if you
knew this. Add it, check it, and uncheck it. What was that? What did you say?
I don't know if you knew this, but you can get gorillas as a thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I haven't done it yet. I still haven't gotten any gorillas, and I'm trying to get to that, too. What's up, Queen? How you doing, babe? I like how everything's not all fucked up like it usually is. Like you don't have to have everything all banged up. You can actually have decent stuff. Not all the windows are broken. You can have a perfectly clean building.
Yeah, but it only took an update for him to realize that.
Alright. Alright, now we're going to put the flat roof in. This is a big freaking factory, bro. Way bigger than I was hoping. Well, let me see. I have one, two. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna put this one right in the center. Go right up top there. Is that gonna work there? Come on, come on. There you go. Yummy, yummy, yummy. I got food in my tongue. No! Come on, clip. Clip. Damn it. Come on. Come on. There you go. Now, back up. Clip.
Clip.
There you go. Nice. Alright, that's good. But that one seems to hold up. I know there was a one with an angle that had a piece of wood in it. This one right there. That's perfect. That's the one I want. Yeah, I like that. I like that factory look to it. Perfect. Oh man, if the flooring was to just drop, that would come down hard. Those would come down crashing hardcore. So hopefully that doesn't happen. Joel, at the moment, I think it's just you, bro. Because over here, I have not had I have no support beams. yeah, Joel, if you look at all the stuff I've been making, nothing has been confusing to me, but I can usually figure this kind of stuff out anyways, so it's never a huge problem for me. But I know some people have a hard time doing this, but I do have videos that show how to do this stuff, and definitely you can go back and watch this video later on, and you can see how I did most of the stuff that I have right now. And I've believe it or not, in the few hours that I've been working on this, I've done a lot. So there's a lot that can help you. So definitely go back and watch this video. It should help you with most of your questions on the stuff that we have right now. I like turtles too, man. But I want my ninja. I want my ninja. I like turtles. Bro, this fucking factory is pretty damn cool, man. And I haven't even done anything, bro. Look at everything I've done, and I haven't done shit. Look at that. Okay, let's step back. Believe it or not, that building is freaking huge, man. But it looks like a factory. Do we concur? Oh, Petey, sounds like he's out cold. I said, do we concur?
And what? Sorry,
kind of space now. Need light. I'll need light. Well, that's why this place has a lot of glass. Actually, hold on. You might be right about that. Ooh, that one looked good right up on top of this building. Probably gonna have to get up on top of this building later. Oh, look at them there. Those are the ones I was looking for. Ain't that some shit? Look at that. Too little, too late. Oh, look at that. Look at everything I've done but haven't done shit. Made shade, you'll need light. That makes perfect sense, really. But there is plenty of light coming in here from every angle. That's why I put the glass windows. But depends on what I'm building, really. Just bought contraptions. Any tips? Yeah. Make a lot of resources. Get as much resources as possible. Like, literally, get resources everywhere you can. Because, bro, you're going to need them.
I can't believe I somehow managed to be able to build everything I wanted to build.
Okay, which one of my tells you how to get resources? The where to find resources video. Okay, doors. Here we go, doors. We want this garage door. Come on, man. Mama Murphy in stocks. Oh, don't worry, that bitch is gonna get into some stocks. And then after I'm done, she's gonna buy stocks and bonds. How you like them? All right, let's go ahead and put a power here. I'm gonna put a switch right on the door. Yeah, it is very simple. Open sesame! And I could have just taken this cable and put it over there. Would have been simpler here. Way more, there we go. Way more out of the way. There we go. And now, machine functionalities! Yeah, that's gonna be the fun stuff. Now, let me put a ramp to go up and down. That's not gonna work. Doors. Woo! Yeah, I'm good at Fallout, bro. The conduits?
I can't wait to
Yeah, I'm gonna have to check the conduits out, bro, because I have heard a few people say that the conduits aren't working well. So, but I'll be the judge of that. I'll be your savior.
I can't wait to have the vault competition thing.
Bro, vault competition, bro, I'm gonna eat you alive on that.
Nah, when I get the mod, like when I have the mods to get like the unlimited supplies, I don't think so, because I'm gonna go for small details, like tables with like drinks.
Peyton
on
says
them,
he needs
just,
to
like,
get to bed. Yo, I forgot.
What?
Where the hell are these ramps?
They're in the warehouse stairs or whatever. If you're looking for the ramps, like, you know, stair ramp.
You gotta re-download Fallout. Why? Ew. There's a roof. Walls. Let me check the wall.
Wait, did someone tell me that I need to go to bed?
No, somebody will have to go to bed. That somebody has to... Echo has to re-download his shit. And some other guy said that he was gonna... He needs to go to bed.
I was gonna say, I'm like, I've stayed up way later than what I am doing today. So, like, yeah.
What's a bed? corrupted data. The enemy, the Fallout enemy. Bro, I literally cannot find where the ramps are at. Oh, hold up. It's in scaffolding. There we go. That's right. Here we go. Now, let's see if we can get this to go right. Let's see. This. Raise it just right. Get a perfect line. Back it up. Zoom in. Move it in. Now, see if we can get these other ones to clip. If we can get them to clip, it'll be perfect. They don't clip. That's just fantabulous. It would have been nice if these things could clip to each other. But they don't. So, oh well, that's not a big issue. I know, so do I. Yeah, I saw that, Mr. Zarkana. That kind of sucks, bro. All right, hold on. Put that there for the moment, and then we'll pull ahead and put this one there for the moment as well, and we'll go ahead and start moving this close. That should be decent. Yeah, man, the scaffolding should snap. That's one thing that should snap. I don't understand why the scaffolding doesn't snap. That's like a big huge thing. It should snap. Down. Don't go down. No, go down. Some bitch. No, go down. Armor max. Yeah, I know they're separate machines, but I was actually gonna go for the ammo one because, honestly, I run out of that a lot. It's the one resource that I need most. More than anything else. Is ammo. Actually, that looks pretty... Ugh. No, it's not. Aw, man. Damn it. Should have left as it was. comes this month. The mods are coming out this month for a PlayStation 4. Okay, that should be pretty decent. Now let's go make sure this closes. And now we're going to test something else out. Do I play Destiny still? Why are you pushing me? Move, Cal! Shoot, Cal, don't bother me.
You want me to answer that for you?
I haven't played Destiny in a while, bro. I've been doing so many videos, a lot of Fallout stuff, so I haven't really had time to do anything Destiny. For the DLC, hopefully I'll have the DLC to play Fallout. But if not, I'll be doing way more of this. Way more Fallout builds and stuff. And continuing to do stuff for you guys. More how-tos. I know I haven't done enough how-tos lately. I've been in limbo. I'm sorry about that. Give him a bathtub and get him the fuck out of the way. Yeah, right? Fucking Brahmin. Okay. That's as close as I can get right now. So there you go. We have a full workshop. A full build here. And just because I am how I am, that's all that I am. I'm gonna go ahead and do something here. Yeah, none of these scaffolds clip together, which is kind of stupid. It'd be nice if they did. Oh, shit. The thing literally just clipped to the other one. What the hell? It did, but it clipped weird. Oh, go figure. Look where it clipped to the roof. That's funny. It literally clipped to the roof. Unbelievable. What part of the roof? I don't know. Shh, shh, don't say that. Because I have... it's called... I made that word up. Fallout OCD. It's a thing. It's a real thing. When you play Fallout, you know what I'm talking about. Fallout OCD is a horrible, horrible disease. And... I think the world should know. More people should know about this terrible, terrible disease called Fallout OCD. It's a true thing. It happens to every Fallout builder out there. It's very, very horrible because once you have Fallout OCD, you can't ever come back from it, you know. Jesus Christ.
I feel like that's one of those ads that are like, in the arms of, like, today you can donate to help get rid of Fallout OCD.
Help destroy what's damaging our kids nowadays. Fallout OCD. Just $1 a day can... Wait, I'm sorry, really shut up! Don't say that! It's just already killing me as it is, man. But I need to... that's why I'm going to go back later on and do all this stuff. It's contagious as shit, bro. Bro, if you look at all my other builds... Like, the line work is uncanny. Look at that. Everything is so fucking even. I can't help myself. You can see... You can see the OCD in these builds, bro. I mean, that's OCD, sir. That is OCD. And if you haven't seen anything yet, check out my hotel. That's OCD as hell. From one room to the other. That's OCD, sir. That is OCD as hell. Look at this. Each room is exactly the same. The three rooms on the first floor. Bro. OCD style. Look at floor number two. Fallout OCD is a horrible, horrible disease. Look at this. This is my gamer's room. Here, this is all VR.
Oh, you've got a freaking gaming setup in there too.
Yeah, yeah. Mine. Yeah, the second floor hotel room has a gaming center. Looks terrible.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, they are killing logic itself. Mama Murphy has OCD. Look at all the drugs she takes. This is the tiniest room in the hotel. I mean, this is like super, super small. Thanks, man. I have a great video on YouTube about this hotel, the story behind it, and it's actually pretty funny. You guys should definitely check that one out as well. My hotel in Sanctuary Hills. That's a good video, and the commentary is fucking hilarious. You'll laugh your ass off with that one. That one's really, really good. All right, that's enough with the hotel. Let's go back and work on that. You know what? Let's take a shortcut. Oh, we gotta go downstairs. Nick is still following me. We're gonna go right through. Did I not go over to the fourth floor? What the hell?
What the hell, motherfucker? I don't even know.
There's a wealth of technology.
Oh yeah, no. In my video, Piper has the hotel. This is the restaurant. What the fuck? You're the new chef, huh? I don't think that's how you cook, bro. You're all jacked up right now. That's not the way you cook. Ah, I get to use the call button. Yes. Nice. I wonder if I could kill myself. Ah, okay. Okay, so you can connect them. That's cool. Bye, Nick.
Dude, they have a paintball gun.
What?
There's a paintball gun, like cannon thing.
I am gonna put a hotel in my elevator in my hotel. Like, I'm doing all that because I gotta get rid of all those stairs. Those stairs are annoying as hell. I'm actually gonna put two elevators in there.
Dude, no way.
See, believe it or not, these are not just structures. That is an airship, and that's a blimp. That's why you see them floating there. I know it's made of metal, I know. But use your imagination, people. This is Fallout. That's an airship, and that's a blimp. And that's why they float. Those are floating structures because they fly. You know, I'm not just going to put regular floating structures, man. That just doesn't make any sense.
Literally. Don't you have an airship?
Yeah, I have an airship and a blimp. I've seen the junk mortar. I should sleep until day so that way I can get the day back because this nighttime shit is, like, not good. Believe it or not, if you go to the different settlements and just tear down all the wood, that's one of the easiest ways to get wood. And you can get a lot of it, bro. There's a lot of different settlements that you can get. And there is a lot of wood to get, bro. A lot of wood. That is a really, really, really easy way to get. And we're talking about easily you can get way more than 10,000 wood if you go to most of the settlements. And that's a lot. That's not even... more than what it should be. You can get way, way more than that. If they do update physics, I am fucking screwed, bro. Everything's coming down. This whole... My entire world in Fallout is going to shit. Like, buildings are going to come crumbling down on top of each other. Everything is going to get fucked over because there's stuff that should not be held up the way they are because it's way too fucking heavy for from one side than to the other. So yeah, physics would show that none of this stuff should work the way it is. But this is not physics class, this is Fallout class. In Fallout, everything works. Use your imagination. Shit like this works. Yes, I'm gonna build the machines. I had to build the building first. But I'm putting it today again. I'm gonna build some machines right now. Like I said, guys, I'm gonna do this stuff. I'm gonna try and get done as much as possible today with all this build so you guys can check it out. A monument to Adam? That'd be cool. Alright, let's remove one of